went through so many bottles. Oh my god.
Hello, my name is Paul Steindal. I am a gay man in San Francisco. I'm from Norway. And the day I got out of the U.S. Marine Corps, I came out of the closet as a gay man and have always tried to integrate my sexuality and spirituality as a believing Christian. My experience in the military was tail end of the Vietnam War. As a gay man, I was frightened because the Naval Investigative Service, called the NIS, and the Criminal Investigative Division, CID, were continually and perpetually hounding out gay men. They would come into the barracks sometimes at 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock in the morning, taking off their shoes, tiptoeing into the bathrooms looking for homosexuals. And if they found someone in active sexual activity, they tended to be very brutal with them, physically and emotionally. One day, I stumbled onto an individual on Haight Street in San Francisco, and it was literally love at first sight. His name is Crayne Suchi Cam. He was from Hawaii, and he is the love of my life. Crayne died in the 4th of June, 1994, and he's the only person where I felt an integration of my sexuality and spirituality. We were both very spiritual. I had never experienced that before, and I realized now that he was truly my soulmate. It wasn't until I met Crayne that I really was completely blown away by the depth of his spirituality and his concern for mine and the sacredness of intertwining our sexual and spiritual beings together. I had never experienced that before. His death to this very day, even this almost 20 years, has left me feeling a very deep void in my life. I wish I had been taken first. I don't wish that pain on anyone. It is part of the mystery that I don't understand. And surviving the AIDS Holocaust, having lost so many people, all my long-term friends are gone, and then my soulmate. My prayer life has changed. I continually ask God for the grace to continue. And what puzzles me that every year it gets worse. I miss Crayne very much. This picture was taken about 20 minutes before Crayne collapsed, and I had to carry him back to the room. It was really the beginning of the end, about 3 months before his death. And the medications that he was taking were not working. And then the AIDS and cancer were really ravaging his body. And from that point on, it was to watch him slowly deteriorate and about saying goodbye. This photo was taken of my lover Crayne on his deathbed 1 hour after he died. Very painful day for me.
It was even more painful when I got there an hour after his death, and his medical doctor wanted to know who his real family was, and tried very hard to not acknowledge that I was his family. And that very same evening, a good friend of his and I went to our apartment and got his favorite clothing and things that he wanted to be cremated with. And we dressed him up in preparation for his body being put into the body bag for shipment to the crematorium.
When he died, I thought, well, nobody's going to come to his funeral because virtually all his long-term friends were dead. But there were about 250 people that came to his funeral. It was in four languages. We had a halal doing hula. And it was a very powerful service for him. His death has left me feeling devastated. My friend Crayne had a prayer that he read every night, and I would like to read it. O Great Spirit, whose voice I hear in the winds, and whose breath gives life to all the world, hear me. I am small and weak. I need your strength and wisdom. Let me walk in beauty and make my eyes ever behold the red and purple sunset. Make my hands respect the things you have made, and my ears sharp to hear your voice. Make me wise, so that I may understand the things you have taught my people. Let me learn the lessons you have hidden in every leaf and rock. I seek strength, not to be greater than my brother, but to fight my greatest enemy, myself. Make me always ready to come to you with clean hands and straight eyes. So when life fades, as the fading sunset, my spirit may come to you without shame. I'm grateful that I had the experience to have a soulmate who struggled hard to integrate sexuality and spirituality. I always felt so blessed. And I realized to this very day that many of my gay brothers and lesbian sisters have never had that opportunity to have someone who loves God and loves sex. And living this duplicitous life took its toll. And I have found that the more I tell the truth, the simpler it gets. So my encouragement to my young gay brothers and bisexual brothers, come out of the closet. The more of us who come out, the better it gets. And we're living in times where things are rapidly changing. And I have a feeling that part of it is the fact that people who are heterosexual know someone who's gay, knows a person of integrity, a good person, and it has changed their lives. They have been forced to examine their own prejudices about human sexuality. And so to you who are younger, I pray that you have the courage to just simply tell the truth and be who you are. Life is too short. It really is. I'm 63, and it's hard for me to comprehend that I have lived this far. The hope and the possibility of finding a long-term relationship with someone who really cares about you, who loves you, it is so wonderful. I've had that experience, and I just wish my soulmate were alive today. We were very blessed. So I want to encourage you to come out.